Good morning, everyone. Welcome to the Morning Tales for May 18th. And I hope you are watching the 5-day question series for NABARD. That is very, very important for the upcoming NABARD examination. And let's begin with the first question for Morning Tales. So what is the theme of the RBI's Payment and Settlement Systems in India document Vision 2019 to 2021? Important to note this duration as well. Also, important to note or remember the name of the document as well. Another question could be framed out of this thing, that who has published this. So it's important to remember that RBI has come up with this. Now this is a vision document, and obviously RBI would have suggested measures and improvements which needs to be done in the payment and settlement systems of India. So as per this document, the theme for this document is to create highly digital and cash-light society. Now the purpose of RBI to come up with this document is that, the vision document, that they believe that the number of digital transactions in the country is expected to increase more than 4 times, and they believe that it will go up to 8,707 crore in December 2021. So to achieve this number, they have decided to come up with a vision document. Also, we have uploaded different videos for the Niti Aayog's India at 75. That is also important with respect to the examination, be it NABARD or RBI grade B. Moving on to the next question, which of the following Indian Coast Guard ship has been decommissioned at Vishakhapatnam? So recently, an Indian Coast Guard ship, ICGS ship, has been decommissioned recently at Vishakhapatnam. What is the name of that ship? So the name of the ship is ICGS, that is Indian Coast Guard ship Vigraha. It was actually commissioned on April 12, 1990, and now it has been decommissioned in 2019. So 29 years which have been served by this glorious Vigraha. Now one question for you, that there was another ship which has been recently inducted or being commissioned in the Indian Coast Guard ship. The answer for this question is already available among these options. So you need to tell in the comment section below that which ship among these has been recently commissioned as an Indian Coast Guard ship. The next question is, Ministry of Defense has set up a Special Operations Command, the Specialized Tree Services Division, which is named as Special Operations Command, Cyber and Space. So the Tri-Services is Operations Command, Cyber and Space. Now the question is, it was recommended by which committee? In the previous Morning Tales, I already discussed about the new appointment which has been made. The head has been appointed for the Special Operations Division. And who has been appointed as Special Operations Division? He is A.K. Dhingra. Now, you need to answer that on the recommendation of which committee they decided to set up this Tri-Services Division. So basically, this Tri-Services Commands have been, or it was proposed by the Naresh Chandra Committee in 2012. So it was basically recommended in the year 2012, but now finally we have implemented this Special Operations Command, the Tri-Services Division of India. These three Tri-Services, it's important to note that they would be functioning under the Integrated Defense Staff. So three things to remember, that Special Operations Command Cyberspace is the name. It was recommended by Naresh Chandra Committee in 2012, and now A.K. Dhingra has been appointed as the head of the Special Operations Division. The next question is, where is the Indian Navy's first full-fledged SSB, that is Services Selection Board, has been inaugurated for the selection of both permanent and short service commissioned officers? So this is for the first time that Indian Navy's first full-fledged SSB. So there is already the Naval Services Board, which actually recruit the naval officers, but now this time Indian Navy has established a full-fledged SSB, and it has been inaugurated at Kolkata. So if we take into consideration the boards which have been established by Indian Navy, then it's the fifth board which has been established by Indian Navy. The other four boards are established in Bhopal, Bengaluru, Vishakhapatnam and Coimbatore. So this is the fifth board which has been established in Kolkata. Now this is interesting question, as this person has broken his own record. So who among the following has climbed Mount Everest for a maximum number of time. So for the 23rd time, this person has climbed the Mount Everest, which is 8850 meters high, the highest mountain peak in the world. And now this person has created his own or broken his own world record of climbing the Mount Everest by climbing it one more time. So Kamiriti Sherpa is the person who has climbed it for the 23rd time, breaking his own world record. Actually, he started in the year 1994, and till then, in 2018, he again created the world record of climbing it for the 22nd time, and that too was the world record. Now he has climbed it for the 23rd time. He is 49-year-old person, and now he has created a record of most summits on Mount Everest. He is from Nepal. Remember this thing. The next question is, what is the name of the NASA's mission to send human, particularly women, to moon? Now, it's a very shocking news that till date, no woman has gone up to moon. So, for the first time, NASA has decided that they will again send humans to moon, and particularly they would be including women for this time. Also, they have decided, or they have given the name to this NASA mission, which was originally scheduled for 2028, but now they have preponed it to 2024. What is the name of the mission? So it's, the name is Artemis, which has actually been acquired from the Greek deity who is associated with the moon. So it was in news because of two reasons. First of all, they have given up the name to this mission, Artemis, and now this mission actually requires 1.6 billion of additional funding to go forward. Now there are two questions for you. The first one being, as per Geological Survey of India, which state in India has the highest graphite reserve? So it was recently found out in this survey that the state has around 35% of the graphite reserve, which is the highest found in the country. So you need to answer in the comment section below that which state has been identified with the highest graphite reserve. Very, very important question. And another question which is up for you is, Checkmate is the leading lifestyle brand of which cricketer? So through this, the person is actually making his presence in the field of entrepreneurship. Now the hint for this question is that the person is also the chess player. So who among the following is the chess player as well, who has launched his own lifestyle brand, Checkmate? Hope you are watching the 5-day question series for NABARD Grade A and Grade B examination. Do not forget to subscribe to our channel and press the bell icon as well, so that you do not miss on any of the updates when we are posting the videos. And thank you so much for watching the video.